Every year, we round up some random Christmas gift recommendations for the gamers in your life. Or maybe just for yourself. I don't know. We got a wide range of stuff here, in no particular order, ranging from normal stuff to obnoxiously expensive stuff if you just want a window shop. So with that disclaimer, jumping right into it at number 10, we might as well get the big elephant in the room out of the way. The most obvious thing, dudes, PlayStation 5 and Xbox Series X. Yes, this is the ultimate thing to give a gamer for Christmas, obviously, but we're talking about if you can even get these things. We know they're not exactly easy to get, but if you can happen to snag one, you'll be seen as a god in the eyes of whoever you give it to. I mean, who wouldn't want a next-gen console? Or maybe even a next-gen graphics card. And it seems like PS5 is a little bit harder to get. It seems like it's the most coveted one in mainstream popularity, which we get because there's Miles Morales and Demon's Souls, which are both really awesome, but unfortunately, scalpers have been going after the PlayStation 5 like crazy, so you're gonna have to be pretty quick with the checkout process if you're gonna snag one. Be ready on your phone, be ready on multiple browsers, know the F5 key and know it very well. We also recommend following deal websites on social media. We highly recommend @Wario64 on Twitter. He'll always post when they go live, wherever it may be it Best Buy, Walmart, a random mom and pop store, or BJ's or Sam's Club, anything. A lot of these accounts are really good and really quick. Anytime new consoles are listed for sale, even if there's just a few, they'll let you know. It's absolutely frustrating, but if you are patient, we've seen a lot of people luck out. If you didn't get one day one, maybe you'll get one down the line. And like we said, scalpers out there are selling them at a higher markup. We've said it in other videos, we're gonna reiterate it here. We suggest not supporting that. They're definitely taking the fun out of Christmas if you ask us, but this isn't even really a Christmas gift idea of a video. This is more of a tip point, but anyway, let's move on over to number 9. We're just gonna rattle off some random cool PC gaming stuff. We tried to think outside the box a little bit here with this one. First, we have this foot control pedal board that plugs in via USB that's pretty much a macro pad, which you can use in games to trigger chat or maybe crouch or whatever you want depending on how you play. Maybe they're into flight simulators or really into Star Wars Squadrons and would appreciate a flight stick. Here we have the Thrustmaster T1600M FCS. It's a really good solid choice, but if you want to save a few bucks, there's the Logitech Extreme 3D Pro joystick, which is only around 40 bucks, but you have to find it in stock. It kind of comes and goes because the release of Star Wars Squadrons really kind of amped up excitement on this one. Also, we recommend a mouse bungee. That could be a cool kind of different gift. There are a few of them out there. There's the Thermaltake, the Sports Galeru bungee, which has a non-slip base and uses a magnet to keep a good sturdy hold on your mouse cable. There's also the Razer mouse bungee that's a bit more basic, but it gets the job done and has a very flat design like a lot of other Razer products. We just kind of wanted to point out some weird extra things because when it comes to maybe a specific keyboard or monitor or mouse, the PC gamer themselves is gonna know what they want and they're gonna pick that out. So we tried to pick some other things that you could get for them that you can't screw up as much. Now over at number 8, we have the Elgato Stream Deck, which is something we've recommended in numerous videos, and it's something we won't stop recommending because it's pretty awesome. There's just so much that you can do with it. It's not just a tool for streamers. Keep that in mind. Yes, if you're getting it for someone that's streaming, they're gonna love it. Being able to switch scenes, clear chat, trigger on-screen effects, and stuff like that with a push of a button, it can really make the streaming process and the whole situation much easier. But even if they don't stream, they'll have a ton of fun with it. There's Philips Hue integration now, so you can control your Hue lights with it. You can set it up like a macro pad, like a really fancy macro pad. You can take a screenshot or trigger screen recording. You can display your CPU usage right on a button, like all of it. The options are limitless. You can control your entire rig with this thing. It comes in multiple sizes now. There's a small one that's pretty affordable. There's the original one and a really big one. So you have some options to choose from. And like we said, we can't recommend this thing enough as more of a unique special gift. Now next at number 7, one thing that's often overlooked is just picking up one of the many gaming-centric subscription services. It's always a very safe, but easy and rewarding gift. Even if they already have that service, you can just give them another year's worth and they can just tack it on to their current subscription. Xbox Game Pass Ultimate is a very good get. For the price, you get Xbox Live Gold, Xbox Game Pass, and Xbox Game Pass for PC. There's a ton of games available on the service and they are always adding more, plus they get access to any Xbox first party game the day that it releases. I mean, think about it, the gift of a bunch of video games, there's not much better than that. It's not just one-sided though, PlayStation Plus is good too. It's needed to play online, and with the PS5, Sony launched the PlayStation Plus Collection, which gives you access to a handful of first party Sony games as well as some third party games. Nintendo Online is great for Switch players, it gives them multiplayer access and they can play a bunch of old school NES and SNES games. Apple Arcade Arcade is also overlooked. It's another great option for iOS users. There are some actual quality games on there, not just kind of like the shovelware mobile stuff. There's some good quality stuff, even to the point like that new PlayStation 5 game, The Pathless. There's a version of it on Apple Arcade. So there's a lot of options and a lot of different subscriptions. If they're more curious about streaming, you could also try hooking them up with GeForce Now or something like that. Just something new and unique. You have a lot of options here if you can't tell. Now over at number 6, we have the Oculus Quest 2. There are a few gamers out there that are pretty vocal about how they don't care about VR, but I think once they jump into the world of VR, they're gonna have a blast. And the Quest is really cool, with some caveats. It's good quality VR, we'd say similar, and in many cases better than the quality you get with the PlayStation VR, but it's wireless, and the wireless aspect of it is what makes it really cool and actually feels like magic sometimes. There are some awesome games too, you know, Superhot, Vader Immortal, The Climb, Beat Saber, plus there's Oculus Link now where you can plug it into a PC capable of VR gaming and have access to Steam VR games and other launchers. But I gotta say, there is one big issue though with the Quest 2, and that's the fact that you're required to have a Facebook account. That's gonna be how it is moving forward. And if you're like us and you think that that's a big issue and you might not be into that, be sure to think about the person you're buying it for too. Keep that in mind. Honestly, the gift of VR in various levels, if it's something that you can afford, it's definitely worth giving somebody if you want them to experience something a little magical. Now over at number 5, this might sound like a weird one, it's a really good power strip. I don't think people realize how important this stuff is and how the person who opens the gift might be like, oh great, thanks, but then once they actually start using it, they'll thank you later. Think about how much stuff that person might have plugged in, especially if they're a gamer. You know, they might have 2 or 3 consoles if they're crazy, a TV, maybe a controller dock, a smart speaker. You're gonna have to keep all that stuff from power surges, and they do happen. And if they're not a console gamer, they're a PC gamer, chances are they have even more stuff plugged in around their desk. A normal surge protector works fine, but if you want to go a little hard, there are options. There's this one from TP-Link that has smart features, so you can control it via an app or use your Google Home or Alexa. It also has 3 USB ports, which you'd be surprised, it's actually super helpful and comes in handy. Then Belkin has one, which has double the outlets over the TP-Link one, and 8 of them swivel, which makes plugging things in that have a thick box-like plug much easier. But you lose out on the smart features. But still, personally, we think if we were gifted one of these, we would be pretty hyped. It would be pretty useful. Now over at number 4, for those PC gamers, something a bit unique, we have the Logitech G PowerPlay Wireless Charging Mat. It's a mouse pad that charges your wireless mouse. Why don't we have 10 of them? And nothing is worse than having to cut a gaming session short because your mouse died if you are the type of gamer that opts for wireless. With this type of thing, you don't have to worry about it. Yes, it only works with certain Logitech mice like the G502 Lightspeed, the G703, the G903 Lightspeed, and Pro Wireless Gaming mice. So if they don't have one of those, they can't use this. Or you can get them 2 gifts and get them a mouse to go with it, but that's usually a little bit more trickier. Wireless mice are, thankfully, finally at the point where you don't really have to worry too much about input lag, which is something that some of us were very wary of for a while. Like I said, it's not much of an issue though, and Logitech makes some of the very best wireless mice you can get. No, we're not sponsored by that. But for gaming and just normal mouse stuff, this mouse pad thing might seem kind of gimmicky, but it is definitely one of those not lame gimmick gifts. Now over at number 3, let's talk chairs. A good proper chair is very important to your health, and chances are you have a gamer out there with a really crappy chair, and that crappy chair that they're spending a lot of time in is actually really affecting their quality of life. If you really love someone and you want to show it by spending a dumb amount of money on them, boy oh boy do we have the gift for you. You can get them that Herman Miller X Logitech G Embody gaming chair. This thing is crazy, I need a minute to catch my breath. This thing is insane. It looks like the most comfortable desk chair ever. Plus, the coolest thing, it looks like a gamer chair without actually really looking too much like a over-the-top gaming chair, if that makes any sense. And the ergonomics is the focus, the comfort is the most important thing here. The chair, although expensive, also has a really good warranty, but we're kind of using this as a jumping off point. Obviously, that's the highest end chair, but there are plenty of affordable chairs out there for the gamer in your life. You don't always need to go and consider one of those race car looking gamer chairs, because not all of them are the best for your posture, and a lot of them are overpriced. Really, the value is just you taking a minute to do your research and find someone a damn good chair. There are affordable chairs out there, you can find them, you just gotta know where to look. We don't have time to cover all of them here, but we just wanted to like kind of give you guys a tip. Now down to number 2, people like to rag on mobile gamers, but they are out there, and with stuff like Apple Arcade, which we mentioned earlier, and Xbox's cloud streaming service, and Nvidia GeForce Now, it's more real than ever. Playing on a phone screen can get old real quick though, so why not give them an accessory to make it a bit more bearable? The Razer Kishi is a neat gadget that kind of turns your phone into a Nintendo Switch, and we've tested it and we think it's pretty cool. You unfold it, you pop your phone in, and you're gaming. It works extra well with xCloud and GeForce Now because those are console games for the most part that control a bit more traditional than your average mobile game, but be aware of which one you're buying because they don't work with every phone. There's an iOS one that has a Lightning port and one for Android phones with USB-C. Razer only makes it with these two ports, so make sure to check and make sure it's compatible with whoever's phone you plan on giving it to. Now down to number one, most gamers and nerds in general just love stuff. Random bullshit. Thankfully for you and us, there's a lot of stuff out there and we like to kind of go above and beyond your dollar store bargain bin Funko Pop. Places like IM8Bit and Fangamer have more gamer-centric stuff that's a bit more high quality. Then there's Etsy. Don't overlook Etsy. There's a lot of really cool stuff on there. You can strike gold there, especially with cool, creative, handmade stuff. But then there's other stuff like this power bank that's also a retro game console that has 416 games pre-installed and can give you 2 to 3 charges on your phone or 48 hours of play. Now, on that topic of retro games, there's the Pocket Sprite, which is a keychain-sized emulator machine. I mean, this thing is tiny. I don't know how they even managed to do this, but it's pretty cool. It also comes preloaded with a bunch of games, and you can add more emulators to it from your computer. Now, also, remember Oregon Trail? You can get this really neat Oregon Trail handheld game, like those Yahtzee or Solitaire plastic handheld games that were big back in the day. It's even modeled after an old-school PC. It even has a fake little floppy disk drive on it. This thing isn't always in stock, but you might be able to snag one on a restock, and it's just incredibly unique to give someone. And last but not least, probably if you're looking for more of a stocking stuffer, consider one of those UV blue light glasses. Maybe a pair of Gunners or any other equivalent or more affordable brand if you want to protect people's eyes. These types of glasses are designed to help eye strain and protect your eyes a bit from those bright screens all night, so it's actually pretty thoughtful. And honestly, that's what we try to do for this whole video. Think of gifts that are a little bit more thoughtful, a couple different spins on the standard stuff. We'd love to hear from you guys in the comments what Christmas gifts you're getting for the gamer in your life. Anything at all, any tips or suggestions you can give for other people watching this video, we'd love to hear that. If we did help though, clicking the like button does help us out. We would really appreciate that. And if you're new, maybe consider subscribing, hitting that notification bell, because we put out videos every single day. But hey, as always, thanks for watching, and we'll see you guys next time.